How much does a polar bear weigh? Enough to break the ice. I'm Gavin Noble, 28, I'm from Ireland, and I'm an ITU professional athlete. I'm specialised is new to ITU, and I've been on the circuit now for 3 or 4 years. ITU differs from Xterra and maybe Ironman in that the races are shorter, arguably at a faster space, speed, higher intensity. I would argue then that the depth in the ITU racing is the best in the world. And on my specialised, I'm hoping to do as well as I can for them. ITU racing involves getting there 2 days early, which is a sticking point with me. But when we get there, it's swim, bike, run, same as Xterra, same as Ironman. We swim 1,500 metres in the open water. We bike 40Ks, normally around a city centre course, which is fast, dynamic and technical. And then we run to the finish. A lot of the ITU guys just now, the most important thing is getting to run as fresh as possible. That's not to say that it's a run race. We have to be very, very fast swimmers, very efficient in the water. We have to be able to get out with the leaders to get on the bike as fresh as possible. And then within the bike, we have to be tactically aware. We have to defend ourselves. We have to be, smart. We have to race smart. It's not about who's the best biker. It's about who can get to the run in the best possible shape. And to do that, you have to be the best biker you can possibly be. Once we're on the 10K run, it's every man for themselves, and that first K is a war, and who can hang on the longest to that speed, who's got the speed endurance. A friend of mine says that the winter training is the race between 2 and 8K, and once you get to 8K, then it's just guts, and the guys with the guts, the speed and the talent, they rise to the top. I have many memories obviously of ITU racing, but did you know that Ireland, I'm obviously Irish and I'm proud to be Irish, and the first ever drafting race was in Ireland back in the day in Derry, and I was a young swimmer with my family going to competition, and I witnessed the first ever ITU drafting race in Derry in Northern Ireland, and from then on I sort of became intrigued with it all, and I went to World Champs in 1997 and saw Chris McCormack win a world title in a very, very small pair of Speedos. And it was amazing. It was one of those things where the ITU at that time maybe wasn't as strict, and there wasn't as many rules in place, so the crowd were everywhere in the course, and I was just one of the many thousands of people that day in Perth watching Chris McCormack run 10 metres ahead of Hamish Carter and Simon Lessing for the whole 10K run, and that's something that really inspired me, and something that I always remember, and something that other young people, I'm sure that other people were there on that day as well, and they've remembered that day, and and that's maybe why why I started, and maybe why I'm still here. ITU racing has evolved every year since I've been involved, and sometimes it's very hard to keep up every year. The depth increases, there's more and more guys. When I first started out, and when I was younger and I looked at ITU racing back in the day, maybe only 10 to 12 guys would come out of the water at the same time, and then there was more of a chain gang in the bike, and from those 10 guys who come out of the water, those were the guys who would fight for the win. But each year it evolved, so the swimmers got quicker, more guys can now swim that speed. Guys that are swimming maybe sub 16 minutes in the pool for 1500 metres. And it's aggression, you have to get out there. It's the toughest man will win, the strongest man always wins ITU racing. And even ITU racing today, if we cross over to non-drafting or Olympic distance, it's the ITU, the racers who are former ITU racers who are rising to the top. So I believe that ITU racing at the moment, is the pinnacle of our sport, and it's from ITU racing which the other aspects of our sport evolves.